my soul, my will is to get lined up in that thing. Because you know what, saints, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm gonna tell on myself. I'm on my wife. She don't mind. She'll just tell on herself. But that's not really me. When you move from seeking the love, seek the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and you start working on adding those things simply because you think that He's not moving fast enough, that you're in danger. That's dangerous territory. You're telling the King of Kings and Lord of Lords He's moving too slow. You don't know what I need. It's like you're getting money. That's why I get a little nervous. So some people say they get money and they start saying, I'm going to get him and I'm getting him. And I'm like, you're trying to do his job. And he ain't going to give you no money. Because you don't know what he's doing him. So you're trying to preempt his plan, his will. Because you're trying to. If they're hungry, he knows they're hungry. Yeah. Now if he told you to give it to him, give it to him. It's not yours at that point any longer. But you cannot just start saying, I'm gonna, because your garments can be the millstone around somebody's neck, because they're not ready for it. I just think that everybody was, but he had to set me down and tell me that that is not so. No, they will. Somebody said, that's gonna hurt. Real quick, in a hurry. There's enough goodness in the land of living for us to do everything. To get up from here and believe him for everything, to walk where he wants us to walk, to talk. It's enough for us to clean up the church. It's enough for us to go through the neighborhood and knock on doors. It's enough for us to get ready and say, when we fasting again, when we turn this plate over for another week, because this you done already told, I know it's enough strength that I can do it. I know you're going to keep me, so let's just go and get with the thing, because I'm just only going to do better. I'm only going to be stronger in the Lord when the thing is all done. Well, it's enough goodness. We went through it, so nobody can never bamboozle us about it and tell us that we're crazy, that you can't do it. We can't. He healed. What grace would you have? Colon cancer? Huh? What? We maxed that stuff down. Christian, they thought your father, the pictures look bad. But he alive and well? He moving? I bet he's praising God this morning. Shake it and tell him, no, you can't talk to me. I don't know if you're like myself, sometimes they're trying to back you down and just try to put you in a hole and make you feel bad and get up, repent. I did say it. I did do wrong. Forgive me. I pray that in time they'll forgive me. And you got to go on. Saints, there is enough goodness in the land of the living for us to finish this thing up. I know. When you start talking about time, you start saying, this generation. I think you better knock some generations off. I think he's coming. I think he's coming soon. We've been talking about it for over 2,000 years, that he's coming back. The disciples thought he was coming back in their time. He said he raised that thing up in 3 days. And if 1,000 years is like one day and 2,000 days is gone, and he's going to raise it up in 3 days, we're close to that third day. Think about it. A year, 1,000 years like a day. It's 2,000 years ago. Over 2,000 years they carried. We're getting close to that third day, saints. Bless God. If anybody, I know this is not one that you might want to give your life and rededicate, but if please stay. Because I know they don't want to rededicate Reverend Walker. They want to go on. They want to tell the story. Mama. That's all you want to come and dismiss us.
If there is anyone, then you know, Lord, I just need the strength to wait on the Lord. I believe you. Help me to see the goodness of God that's all around me. Because that goodness will encourage me to just keep standing. You can come forward at this time. We thank the Lord for his word this morning. Let me just assure you, God is able. He is so able. Whatever it is, God is able. We serve a great God. He's a big God. He is the victor. And because of that, we are victorious. Those of you that are at the altar this morning, I want you to get it in your heart and in your spirit that nothing can overtake you. You are more than a conqueror through Him that has loved you. Wait on the Lord and trust in Him. Don't trust in your feelings. Don't even trust in what you see. But trust in the Lord, and He will bring you through.